Okay. So now that you've had a chance to look around the park, take it in, and see some of the sights, what's your impression of it? What does it mean to you?
For me, it's kind of feels like home and a chance to get away from the city. I'm not used to
big, so many people,
tall buildings and people, so it's kind of nice. It makes me feel like I'm more at home.
I have to say the same. I think it would be a travesty to ever get rid of it. We were talking about it before we came. We feel like if they try to get rid of some of the park, there'd be two times as many people trying to keep it than get rid of it, just because it holds so many chances. Just because nature, I mean, as pretty as the skyscrapers can be and how majestic they are, nature right next to it kind of holds it in a good balance.
Someone once said it'd just be a concrete jungle.
And now it's a jungle and concrete.
Yeah. this is true. And I don't know the exact history of why they decided to make Central Park, but I think it was just back, they were just starting to run out of, they saw that land was being eaten up by buildings, and they all felt, people, I guess,
needed a place.
We needed to have a sanctuary. We need to preserve some of the water we see that's disappearing in the city. So they had good foresight. So,
absolutely.
Otherwise, we wouldn't be here right now.
And it's funny because the man apparently that designed all of these parks designed the parks where I'm from.
Ah, okay.
Louisville, Kentucky.
And how are those parks?
I love them.
We'll have to go there and
do a
documentary.
Absolutely.
There. What's the name of it?
Louisville, Kentucky.
No, the park.
Oh, all of them. Most of them.
Tom Sawyer?
I don't know about Tom Sawyer, but Cherokee, and there's multiple
Seneca
parks.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, so hold up your Polaroid.
Oh, I put it in here. I want to keep it.
I'm going to give you an envelope.
Okay. So,
Now that I just took that a couple minutes ago, what does that picture represent to you? What meaning does it have for you?
Got this one.
Just something that we'll always keep and be able to look back on. And I just love how pictures take you back to the exact moment of what you were doing, and I'll remember something different than she remembers, and so I think that's cool.
This moment you have. Concrete?
So, have you taken a lot of pictures on this trip of your phone?
Yeah.
So, when you get home,
print them out.
Oh, good.
Well, we might not, but okay. That's an idea.
It's an idea. Well, maybe the tour has motivated you to do that, because most people...
just upload
them, and that's it. They stay in your, look, I'm a photographer, digital, and they stay in my computer. I haven't seen most of them.
It's funny because when we used to go on family vacations, my family and I would buy like 11 disposable cameras, and then the big thing was, oh, we gotta go to Walgreens and develop them. And then we'd get home with like a stack of envelopes, and we just go through them and be like, have you checked this one out?
Right.
You just see how they turned out.
That's great, yeah. I know that feeling with prints, because I have, my family has a closet full of just the prints, stacks over the years. And something we or have lost or losing. So, when you look at your phone, you take a picture of the same exact moment, you give it to a stranger to take a picture of you too. What's the value of each? What each of the Polaroid versus the phone? What are they? Can you describe the different?
Seems more sentimental if it's an actual picture for me, anyway. Like, it holds more meaning than just being on a phone or on a social media. Or with a picture, I feel like you usually store them away, and so you don't necessarily look at them as much as you would on your phone, and then you get them back out, and it's more fun to recall.
And to talk to
them. When it's an actual picture, I think, in my opinion.
So, you're walking by my station here. What caught your eye? What made you say to yourself, I want to get one of those?
I think I know what her answer is.
Well,
black and white.
I love black and white, but I've always wanted to get a caricature or like a drawing or whatever, and those are too expensive. But yours was $7.
Yeah. We were like $3 less, I think. Or I don't know how much of the caricature. What do we have about portrait cards? I do see a lot of old photographers and people older than me know it kind of stop and gaze, and I can tell that they're remembering like it's, and it wasn't that long ago, really, in the grand scheme of things, it really wasn't, and people have forgotten it, to some extent, people who knew it more than I did. When you get home, what are you gonna do with the Polaroid? What's your plan?
Frame it or put it in a thing of all of our tickets that we've had from the pumpkin trip.
Souvenirs.
Okay. So, all right. So, where are you from?
Louisville, Kentucky, and he's from
Bowling Green, Kentucky.
Okay. So, what are your first names?
Christy.
Andrew.
Okay. Well, enjoy your Polaroid. Enjoy the park and. Come back soon, and maybe we'll come visit your park since
there were
designs.
It's not this. None of them are this big.
I'm sure it's got the same feel.
It does.
All right. Well, thank you, and have a safe trip.
Thank you. Oh, baby.